Welcome everyone to the second episode of the Swindon Town Road to Glory. In episode 1, we were able to finish in 3rd in League 2, which does secure us automatic promotion up into EFL League 1, the 3rd tier of England. In the Cups, we didn't have much success, but I think that will hopefully change in this episode. And we're taking a bit of a youth movement, per se. Abbas is now going to be starting at striker for us. As you can see, he's currently in attacking mid. I will be switching him to striker very shortly, but he is only 17 years old at the start of the season. Hepburn Murphy at left mid will likely be benched very soon in favor of Williams, as you can see on the bench, or maybe even Gray or even Parker. We have a lot of young, up-and-coming talent that we promoted from the Youth Academy in the last episode. Plan to do more of that in this episode. And unfortunately for some of these older, stagnant players whose overall haven't changed, they are in very, very high danger of losing their job. And like I said, probably going to get rid of Hepburn Murphy, and I did. $1.2 million he has been sold for. Michael Gray made the decision to start Williams over him. We'll be going on a full year-long loan move to Watford. Joey Jones will be heading to Elanspor for a year out on loan. Godwin Malief, one of our starting center backs, heading to FC Lugano over in Switzerland for just a little over $1 million. Devin Bishop on a year-long loan move to Austin FC. Blake Tracy, our other starting center back, heading to Pogoń Szczecin over in Poland. And Dominic Iorfa is joining the team from the free agents list for obviously free. But he's a 67 overall center back, player I've used a lot in the past, very physical in both speed and strength. Really what I like out of these center backs at these kind of lower overalls, I don't really care how good you are. As long as you're strong enough, you'll be good enough for me. And that's why I did sign Jordan Turnbull as well. A little bit slower, but a little bit more beefy, more traditional of a center back. And I think that pairing between the two of them should do very well. Also, Cole Palmer joining us on loan from Chelsea. When I made this move, this was before he kind of had his little bit of a breakout. So I will certainly be using him a lot over these next two seasons. Coming in at 69 overall, immediately the highest overall player of the team. Only 22 years old as well. So expect to see a lot of Cole Palmer for these next 2 years at least. Saidu Khan has been sold to Konyaspor over in Turkey. And with all this money we got from selling players, setting up a 5-star, 5-star youth academy scout over in Egypt to hopefully get Abbas a couple of teammates to get some defenders. A 4-star, 4-star scout in Algeria to get some physically strong players to go along with Hassan, our goalkeeper. And Moroccan 4-star, 3-star scout to get some attackers. First game of the season now, we'll be facing off against Bristol Rovers. Going to be playing a 4-3-3 holding. A little bit of a different look, but you can see Turnbull, Iorfa starting, Palmer starting, Williams at that left wing is starting, Abbas at striker starting. This team should do very well. I don't know if this is a automatically promoted team, but I do expect us to kind of be in the mix early. Here are the highlights.
Terrific defending to stop them progressing. The referee spotted the infringement, and it will be a free kick in a position of genuine menace. A really good run.
So we went on to lose this game, unfortunately. Just did not look good whatsoever. I mean, you see the expected goals. We only had one. Was just not meant to be our day, and it was not, as we suffer our first loss of the year. Also didn't help that in that game, Romeo Hutton broke his toe. He is out for 3 months. So, just a lot of bad news to start the year. A little bit of good news, though, is Zaid Amin from the Youth Academy. He is a right back who is left-footed that we have to keep it right back for now because obviously the injury to Hutton, but expect him to move to left back in the near future. Salim Ibrahim, Egyptian center back. Nothing too crazy except he's got 72 to 94 potential. good player off the bench. And now, you know, just because the storyline is just always so funny in career mode, we're facing off against Bristol Rovers in the FA Cup. First round of the FA Cup just so happened to be our first game of the year. It's just kind of funny how this works out, but hopefully we can get a little bit of revenge in today's game. Here are the highlights. So we would get our revenge in this game, a 2-1 victory, goal from Abbas, goal from Palmer, who also both had an assist. So, you know, we win when the games truly count, even dating back to last year. But Max Parker will be departing the club for $1.25 million as he will be joining Barnsley. And we're currently in 16th place, 8 points off of relegation, 10 plus points away from promotion playoffs. This is a rebuilding year. It's a year for our young players to kind of develop a little bit, get us a little bit better, obviously heading into the next season. And in the next round of the FA Cup, we drew West Ham. No point in playing that game. We were going to lose regardless. 3-1, lost there. Kenneth Davis on a half-year loan move to Pendikspor. Tariq Uwakwi, starting left back. I have decided to sell him to West Brom, obviously with the promotion of Amin. I said it was going to happen, and it has. But we do have some unfortunate news as Ibrahim, young academy player we promoted, out for 4 weeks. This happened on April 12th. He is officially out for the season. And to replace him temporarily and probably long term is Salim Ali, Egyptian center back, 81 to 87 potential, 64 overall, 16 years of age. I mean, he's going to be our starter. It's just going to happen eventually. Zachary Brown, not immediate starter, but could definitely be in the near future. Same goes for Nick Perry, just guys that could be good for us in the future. Tariq Ibrahim, expect him to be a crucial player for us. 85 to 91 potential, 57 overall, 6'2". Very, very good build for a defensive midfielder. Same goes for Brahim Ali, 57 overall, 81 to 91 potential. A little bit more of a box-to-box player, so might have our new starting defensive mids for quite some time. Gabal Amin, also 86 and 94 potential since defensive midfielder, so looks like we're going to have a little bit of an issue at that defensive midfielder spot since you can really only start two in a team, so kind of see what we look like in the future. But we have a backup player joining a team on a free transfer, and now it's time for, I'm pretty sure this is our last game of the season. It's pretty pointless, but just wanted to get you guys another game in this episode. Also, a look at Ali starting at that center back position, Amin starting at left back, and Williams is a true left midfielder, not just a left winger. But here are the highlights.
Counter-attack is on, options available. Slice it pass. Wonderful chance. Oh yes, a goal! comes. A bit short with the clearance. That's not a bad ball. Oh my goodness! He's caught that so well! Amin on the ball. Perfect tackle. And teammates to play it to. Counter-attacking opportunity.
Well, the fans are driving their team on here, but can they respond with a goal? Time is running out.
...20 minutes to go. Real chance! And it is staring him in the face! And a goal! And making the substitution now. And short it is. Under pressure, can he do it? And defending right on the line. They've got themselves back into it. Will make the change now. Well, the last server hit. Quite what he wanted to produce. Chances on. And you cannot argue.
So he did win the game 5-3. Abbas with the hat trick. And it was really just a crazy game to end the year, but it was a good game to end the year, which is all that we can really ask for. Mustafa Saeed from the Youth Academy, 67 overall, 79 to 94 potential, like literally the day before I just promoted him here. Signed him to the Youth Academy, 6'6". Expect to see a whole lot of him for the rest of the series. Eusebio Escobar, probably going to be a backup striker for us for quite some time. Tariq Ibrahim going on a two-year loan move to Al-Fateh, I believe in Saudi Arabia. And Amin on a two-year loan move to Wrexham, obviously in England. And Brahim Ali to Al-Halig, I believe also in Saudi Arabia. But unfortunately, by 3 points, we missed out on a promotion playoff spot. So close, but just not our year. But I wasn't really expecting it to be our year anytime soon, so we'll work on that in the future. In the FA Cup, obviously knocked out in the third round by West Ham United. Carabao Cup, knocked out by Port Vale in the first round. The EFL Trophy, we actually made it a little bit further than last year. 4-1 out in the third round by Derby. Kinsella, leading appearance player for us with 45. Abbas had 43. And then you have the rest of the main starters in Hassan, Iorfa, McCarrickan, Kane, Williams, and Turnbull. 16 goals for Abbas, 12 goals for Palmer. Definitely the two strongest points of this attack, as Palmer led the team in assists. And contract-wise, as you saw, Gasini and Braun will be leaving the club on free transfers. Abbas, most valuable player at $5.5 million, just behind him, actually technically tied, is Cole Palmer at $5.5 million. So definitely going to be relying on these two a lot next season. Overall, as a club, we've played 110 games, 45 wins, 27 draws, 38 losses. Not the greatest of records. But the overall of everyone on this team is slowly just going up and up and up. This really looks like a true promotion challenging League One side, if I've ever seen one. So next episode, just slight improvements. If we even make any, might just, again, invest more in the Youth Academy to again put us in a position to do a whole lot better. But hopefully you guys have enjoyed this episode. Next episode should be coming out quite shortly. And if you missed the first episode, want to kind of see who half these players are I'm talking about, go on ahead, hit that. I mean, it'll probably be the recommended video after this, but also just hit the playlist tab and you'll be able to see all my EAFC 24 videos. Hopefully you guys did enjoy. Subscribe if you did. And I will see you all for episode 3.